friends, and today in our studio we have the very talented script writer, screenplay writer, dialogue writer, lyricist, the duo who have done a lot of work so far, and they're coming up with interesting work. I'm talking about Siddharth and Garima. Welcome guys, welcome to Midday.
Hi, thank you.
Garima, first and foremost, I think I should start first of all when we say script writing, dialogue writing. I think most of the terms we understand, but right. Can you just explain what screenplay is? Because perhaps many people do not have an idea what a screenplay is.
Right, okay. So, technically speaking, screenplay... and the screenplay, okay. So, technically speaking, screenplay is something which is... which when I first heard, but when Siddharth and me were writing Ramila, our first film, so we didn't even realize that after writing the story, we had actually written down the screenplay. So, it sounds very technical, but it is actually something which has got to do with... For example, we are sitting here, okay, and... I have walked in, I have picked up this cup of coffee. Till this far, this is a screenplay. And the moment I start speaking something that is dialogue, it's as simple as that. Okay. So the actions of a character are a screenplay. That's how simple it is.
So the way we execute the story on screen, that's what screenplay is.
Yeah, basically screenplay is something that you see on the screen. The way it plays out on the screen, suppose I pick up a glass, so the character goes for the glass, he takes a sip of the water.
Okay.
So that's what is screenplay. It's nothing technical actually, and apart from that, the fact that it binds a scene together, how it is connected to the other scene is also screenplay. Like, you know, how you cut from one scene and you go into the other scene, that is a screenplay. Like, suppose I end this scene with, I walk out of here. Cut to... You say cut to, like, that's a very commonly used term. So you say cut to, someone else walks in from the door and falls down. You know, that's screenplay.
Okay.
So that is primarily.
Absolutely. Yeah. How a story unfolds on screen, because what happens is when I'm telling you a story like this, the visual element is missing from there, okay? It's just me, I'm trying to take you into a world. But when a film is being shot, when a film is being shown to somebody, you follow a certain visual movement also. So it is all three characters combined, all three things combined, visual, audio, and the story that is going in the background, you know? Keeping the characters in mind. But don't worry, screenplay is so technical. My mom still doesn't know what exactly we do. She tells people, "Meri beti story likhti hai."
So that's simpler.
It's simpler.
That's simpler, yeah.
But I think you guys have made it sound very simple. But I'm very, very sure that it is not that simple when you actually have to work at it. Right. So tell me, how did you get into all the script writing and, you know, screenplay writing or dialogue writing for Bollywood? How it all started?
Do you want to take this one?
Yeah, basically, see, we always used to write poetry as, you know, kids, like any other writer for that matter. But then we as we evolved as writers, we thought we want to tell stories. So up now, there is the only way of telling stories in India is I feel, a film.
Yeah.
That's the widest possible commercial format where you can tell a story. You can write a book, but again, that's a different audience altogether. So if you want to tell a story, that's how... We thought that's the best way to do it.
Right. And how we got into Bollywood is a very interesting story. It is almost like a filmy story.
Oh, wow. So, and I want you to say, narrate it in a way, a scriptwriter would,
yes,
dialogue and all that.
So, one fine day, you know, Siddharth and me were sitting in, we used to write reality shows earlier. So, we were sitting and writing one such show. And we got a call in the middle of that from someone, from a friend, who said that Sanjay Leela Bhansali is looking for writers and he just wants to meet some fresh people. So, do you know, I mean, it's still unbelievable. I just picked up the phone and I said, "Arey yaar, abhi to deadlines hai, abhi aaj nahi hoga." And I kept the phone. And then Sid, of course, said, who was it? So I said, "Sanjay sir." He was like, "Sanjay sir wants to meet us. Let's just go." I mean, even if it, you know, it's another thing whether it works out or not. So we just drove in our Spark and we drove at like a mad speed because we had to meet him in the next 1 hour. And that time the idea was just to have a cup of tea with him. And there was no talk of any film or anything. And he just spoke to us. He asked us what are our favorite films. And we were just too... He's one of our favorite filmmakers, you know. Back then we were fans. So we just...
We still are.
We still are.
Sure.
So we sat and had that cup of tea with him. And now he puts it ki mujhe to 2 minutes mein pata chal gaya tha jab tum dono walking kiye the ki ye dono meri agli picture likhenge.
Oh, wow.
So that was quite a thing. And then he gave us some 3 ideas out of which we picked out Ramlila, Romeo and Juliet in a violent setting. And because we totally fell in love with the fact that we will get to do a violent Romeo and Juliet for him. Like a really... you know, volatile sort of a equation between the lovers. So that's something we tripped on, and we didn't know we could write films then.
Yeah.
So had he seen your work earlier, any of your work? It was just that meeting.
No, actually when we went, we thought ki are ye to bahut lyrical kind of films banate hain. So we took a printout of all the songs, all poetry that we had written. We took it to him and he said ki no, I'm not interested. I don't want to make another lyrical film.
Okay.
I just want to make a different, vibrant film. So he didn't go through that, all of that. It went waste. So, but then he said, ki, you had energies. You guys both. And he is a guy who works on instinct. वो अपने ऐसे डिसाइड करते हैं एक मिनट में कि ये बंदा मेरा म्यूजिक करेगा फॉर नो राइम और रीजन बट सो दैट्स हाउ इट इज
बेसिकली आफ्टर ही गिव अस द जर्म ऑफ रोमियो जूलियट ही आस्क्ड अस टू कम बैक विद अ स्टोरी एंड सो देन सिडनी टुक अबाउट 15 डेज टू क्रैक अ स्टोरी व्हिच इज लाइक अ टर्न अराउंड व्हिच यू सी इन डम्बी लेटर व्हिच इज अ टर्न अराउंड ऑन व्हाट रोमियो जूलियट एक्चुअली इज एंड ही फेल इन लव विद इट ही सेड आई वांट टू डू दिस एंड देन ही रियली शोड अ लॉट ऑफ फेथ इन अस बिकॉज हमको पता ही नहीं चला कब वो स्टोरी से स्क्रीन प्ले बन गया फिर उसमें डायलॉग्स लिरिक्स भी हम साथ में लिखते चले गए यू नो ही कंपोज्ड इट सो ब्यूटीफुली एज यू नो ऑफ द राबीला सॉन्ग्स
या या
सो वन थिंग आफ्टर द अदर
बट यू नो रोमियो जूलियट सेट अप इन यू नो इन अ विलेज इन गुजरात एंड देन यू से दैट थोड़ा उसमें डिफरेंस भी लाना था सो हाउ यू नो हाउ इजी आई वुडन्ट से बट हाउ डिफिकल्ट इट वाज एक्चुअली To kind of change it.
It was challenging more than you know interesting and any challenge is interesting for any writer I feel. When you get to a dead end only you will rise. So that is the idea and neither of us is from Gujarat. So he sent us to Gujarat and he said he gave us a car and he said roam around, absorb and whatever. He didn't give us an itinerary. So we went there. This is after making the story. So then we went there. We stayed there for 15-20 days.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So we came up with a lot of stuff from there. Which is there in this thing now, in the final draft now, in the final film also.
Yeah.
So it was more of a challenge, I feel, than.
Correct. It was a challenge, but what happens with him is he doesn't want you to go with a plan or be prepared with it. His whole thing is go and explore and absorb. So he would also take us on his costume recce. Like, as writers, we were literally the part of everything in that film. So now, wo aadat aisi lag gayi, we are now so used to that stuff that we go on all our films ka shoots. We are a part of everything. We are literally co-producing whatever we write. So
I was about to, you know, it was there on my mind because I was just going through the research and I saw your pictures like shooting in Mauritius for Raabta.
Right.
And I was like, why do script writers and screenwriters
have to
get
a lot
of that? We get that very often. Yeah,
but
very
why
often.
Is that? How does that help?
So basically, we are people who, we write a script. Okay, ideally your job is finished. You take your paycheck till that point and you can disappear.
Mm-hmm.
But for us, it is very important that how our scenes are being executed. We need to be there for that. Because wo jo energies hote hain of that live scene happening in that moment, you never know what else you can get over there. You know, so we are very greedy like that. We want to constantly enrich the scene with it.
Mm-hmm.
Or else also be there to see, ki, is it going in the right direction? Because sometimes you can get surprises on an edit. Ki, arre yaar, humne likha kuch tha aur ho kuch gaya. You know, so that is something that we don't allow. That is, uska scope nahi hota hamare liye. Because it is that one thing we live for. Phir, even if it means ki for months we are there in the shoot and raat hai, din hai, we want to be there and make sure a scene is, you know, done in a way that we have visualized it. That is one thing.
Also, I feel, you know, any film is a medium of collective intelligence. Like once you write a scene with a set mind and then you go, the director brings his own perspective. The actors bring their own perspective. So it has to stay as close as possible to the writer's perspective is what I feel. That's what happens in Hollywood. हमारे देश में ऐसा नहीं होता है बिकॉज राइटर्स डोंट गो ऑन द शूट सो वहाँ पे एक्टर अपना दो लाइन ले आता है वहाँ पे डायरेक्टर अपना पर्सपेक्टिव ले आता है तो फाइनल जो प्रोडक्ट आता है वो शायद कहीं और होता है फिल्म जो लिखी गई थी उससे सो दैट्स हाउ वी डोंट वांट टू वी वांट आवर विजन टू गेट वेयर इट वॉज एंड दैट्स वॉट वॉज विजुअलाइज ऑन द पेपर राइट सो दैट शुड ओनली द ऑडियंस शुड सी दैट ओनली सो दैट्स आवर मेन आइडिया व्हाई वी वांट टू बी देयर ऑन द शूट
Right.
So
yeah.
as you said that director's perspective also
yeah.
comes in there. So as a director, as a filmmaker, how not I wouldn't say interfering, but does change come from Sanjay Leela Bhansali's side that no, maybe not this way because he's also can
yeah.
visualize, you know, different
yeah.
things
yeah.
at the spur of the moment. So how does he work, what's his work style?
See, with Sanjay sir, it is a constantly changing thing. Like last night he would tell you that he loves this scene in a particular way and next morning it can go in a completely different zone.
Yeah,
yeah like even like, what is this? So then you were like, achha, matlab, was I dreaming so far? So that's the way it is. But luckily for us, whenever we have given him options for a particular scene, he has loved all five, if there are five. There were that many actually. So, you know, you just have to be able to... seduce his mind to that extent where he then cannot say no to that. And yes, it can be interfering from either the writer's perspective or the director's. You know, a person can feel like that, but it totally depends on what your equation with the director is. You know, so we try, when we are on our shoots, we try to be extremely accommodating for our director. We only speak up where we feel this is not going right. And 99% of the time it works because, you know, when we speak, we are the only two honest people on the set who tell him, ki, okay, this is not fine. Be it Dinesh Vijan or Shri Narayan Singh, our next director, or Sanjarila Bansali.
And talking about Raabta, because the trailer has created quite a lot of buzz, but then it is like on, if I can, you know, whatever I got from it, kind of reincarnation, which has been dealt with in Bollywood a lot many times. So is that really very challenging to bring it in a different way? Have you tried to bring it in a different way?
Yeah, see, I feel it is a very big risk.
That's why it took
5 years to get made.
Raabta
took 5 years to see the light of the day. Matlab, when it is releasing like now, so it has taken 5 years in the making or whatever because of the changes in the cast and a lot of other things. But having said that, I think it is as safe as it is dangerous, yaar. Ki logon ko aadat hai, unhone karz dekhi hai, unhone ye sab dekha. It's a cliched subject. I'm not saying it is anything new.
People
can connect because they've seen. But only thing is, we have tried to break that cliche, because if you have to break a cliche, you have to show the cliche. Agar aap bolte ho non-violence dikhana hai, toh gun toh dikhani padegi na usme. So that is the idea that we went by. And reincarnation as a subject always seduces a writer. Like, you know, Gulzar Saab has written Mirza now. So late in his career, he's still attempting a reincarnation film. So why not? So that was the idea that he chased.
See, according to me, past life, In today's time, is an extremely risky proposition, because you know, you have the most of your audience is the youth, and youth may or may not connect to this idea. We meet a lot of non-believers, you know. I mean, between us only, there's a believer and there's a non-believer. So you know, pichla janam hota hai ki nahi hai, ye ek sawal hai. But because there is that intrigue attached to it, we are taking that minimum risk. And yes, our whole challenge was to make it relevant to today's times, which is why when you see the current time in Raabta promos, you will see it is like they're like any other couple who have met in today's time. But what if two people meet and they realize ki, yaar, it seems like they're not aware of it, but they could have been Heer Rancha or any other lover from the past. So you know, it's just that one fictional chance that we are taking.
And was it your idea to, you know, to show the reincarnation bit, which we are seeing, it is in some different era altogether, not like Kurz maybe, or you know, other films.
Exactly,
so
yeah.
Why did that happen, like why did that come in your mind?
We wanted to break away from, see, a writer lives in an idealistic world here. Ki jahan religion nahi hoga. Ab aap tabhi to imagination mein jaoge, warna agar aaj ki date mein aap thoda sa 400 saal piche chale jao, Raja Rani and all, you know, it's all, I feel that's done. So we wanted to break that and say ki, there is no religion, there is no language barrier. People spoke Hindi in a different manner, people spoke Urdu in a different manner, and nobody was a Hindu or a Muslim or a Christian or a this thing. And still, love has no language, right? So that's why we wanted to push it that back. Ki jab tak ye sab bhi nahi hua tha, so now what?
So to build up that excitement and exactly. Something fresh and new.
A time when man was far closer to nature. You know, when we had a connection with nature. You know, like the characters in the past life, if you can tell from the promo. Today also one promo has come out, which shows it more elaborately. You know, at that point in time, we were closer to nature. Water had, as an element, had a value for us. So we wanted to explore that time. Not a time when kingdoms and rules and regulations were there. In this also, there will be kingdoms, but the lines are very thin. Okay, so that's
So water, as you mentioned, I read that it's playing an important part as an element.
Yeah.
Why water? How does that connect to a love story, maybe, or reincarnation?
See, water is timeless.
Yeah.
A river is timeless. Like love is. So that's how it is connected to the story, because it flows and it is the kya bolenge, proof that the past existed and the future will come. You know, that stays. Aap kahin bhi jao, the mountains will stay, the rivers will stay. People come and die and move on in life. But that is why it is, that's how it is connected to the story.
Right. Also, wo jo ek funda hota na, filmy funda ki pyar mein doob jana.
Oh.
To humne dua diya apne lovers ko pyar.
That is awesome. And then, you know, there's this period, you know, period film, then a love story set up in a village, and then Raabta, and then toiletic Prem Katha, because you guys have written the film. So it's a drastic change, and it's on a social cause. How different it is to, you know, kind of from those kind of genres to suddenly, you know, something which is so realistic and.
Okay. So, the biggest jhatka that I can tell you that we got this year, last year, was the fact that hum Budapest mein shoot kar rahe the for Raabta, and then suddenly in the month of October, we found ourselves in Nandgaon in Mathura. So, So that's how different
drastic.
It is.
Where, you know, they, in Budapest, the streets are also Wi-Fi. And here in the hotel also, you don't get a Wi-Fi connection.
So yeah. So that's how different it is. No, but on a serious note, the two genres are completely different. We didn't think like this when we were scripting both the films. I mean, it didn't really occur. But these are two stories that immensely fascinated us. So we really wanted to go after them. Toilet Prem Katha was actually born out of our minds when we just read this small headline in a paper about a woman running away from her house. And that's what inspired and, helped us develop a whole story on it. And then we pitched it to Friday Filmworks and they kind of liked the idea. And then we actually put in our own resources and went out and did our research in three states for it. So it was pretty elaborate like that. It needed a lot of research. Everything that
because you can't like really go wrong with that subject, because it's a subject where women are involved, safety of women. It's a very serious issue. Having said that, the film is not so serious. It's a very light take and a very subtle take on the whole thing. Hopefully, it will move people. We really don't care whether it will become a commercial success or not. It should affect people's lives. That's what we are more concerned about. With Raabta, we want it to be a blockbuster, of course. Anybody like everybody. But Toilet is a different film. It appeals to a larger audience where it is talking about a daily need. So, they are two radically different films. And ye actually kahan se hota hai, pata hai? Everybody asks us, ki, what kind of writers are you?
Okay. Yeah.
Can you write rom-com? Or do you write only epic drama? So, we wanted to break that. A writer is a writer now. If you give me a subject like this, I will write anything like that. Mm-hmm. So that's the idea that we wanted to write two different films which are radically opposite to each other. Right.
So maybe comedy would be next, is it? Oh. Would you try
probably,
to? Yeah.
Yeah.
See, there is a lot of humor. If I should sell Raabta also, So Raabta has a lot of humor and Toilet has a lot of humor. So hopefully people will see a lot of comedy in these two films. And of course, it will address a larger issue. The other film, and the one thing that we always believed in was that stories should be told the way they are supposed to be told, so that's something we are striving for even in our future films that we are writing.
Coming to dialogues, it has played an integral part in the movies, but what I feel is nowadays we don't get to hear those कहते ना दमदार डायलॉग कि मैं मतलब वो जो अमिताभ बच्चन की फिल्मों में होता था या फिर कुछ we still remember. So why do you think it's not, we can't hear like nowadays in the right. films today? Why?
I want to thank you for this question and Sid, toh apne dil ki bhadas nahi
karte. So basically, there are in this story, there are two villains. One is a producer who says ki line nahi lagni chahiye.
Okay.
It should sound real. Jaise log aajkal baat karte hain, jaise abhi aap aur hum baat kar rahe hain. So अब ना उस चक्कर में लाइन तो लाइन ही है ना यार, मतलब वो डायलॉग तो डायलॉग ही लगना चाहिए. अब वो बोलेगा मेरा बाप चोर था, तो अब मैं ऐसे बोल रहा हूँ मेरा बाप चोर था, तो इट इज साउंडिंग लाइक अ लाइन, राइट? सो दैट इज अ थिंग. नाउ द सेकंड विलन इज द एक्टर, बिकॉज दे थिंक मैं एक्सप्रेशन से सब कुछ कर दूंगा, यहाँ डायलॉग ही नहीं. अब उनको क्या बताएं कि अमिताभ बच्चन बना है कि जो डायलॉग बोल के, वरना अगर वो साइलेंटली एक्सप्रेशन से सब कुछ कर देते तो आज शायद वो यहाँ नहीं होते जहाँ पे है. So this aping of the West is catching up with us. Ki hum silent cinema karenge. Arre, aping of the West, they shoot in studios. We don't. We shoot in real locations. You have to say the line loudly because there is so much outer external noise. But these things, now it comes with the part where you have to be a writer, so you are able to write it. But the only thing is, it doesn't go to the audience. Wahan pehle aapka producer nikalta hai, fir actor nikalta hai, fir edit pe editor nikalta hai. Bolta hai ki nahi yaar, ye line jaisi lag rahi.
वो सब लोग अपने कांच के कमरों में सुन के बहुत खुश हो जाते हैं. पीपल रियली लव योर ओ व्हाट अ लाइन व्हाट अ लाइन एंड व्हेन इट कम्स टू एग्जीक्यूटिंग इट दे लाइक यार दिस इज साउंडिंग लाइक अ लाइन इट शुड नॉट बी टू डायलॉग ही वी गेट अ लॉट ऑफ दिस एंड इट्स सो फ्रस्ट्रेटिंग. वेरी रिसेंटली वन एक्टर टोल्ड अस ऑन वन ऑफ आवर डब्स दैट यू गाइस आर राइटर्स सो यू विल फोकस ऑन वर्ड्स बट हैव टू सी माय परफॉर्मेंस. अरे हाउ आर यू सेपरेटिंग परफॉर्मेंस फ्रॉम वर्ड्स यार? वर्ड्स आर व्हाट विल मेक यू. आपका साइलेंस तो ठीक है ना, हमने पुष्पक भी देखी थी बहुत साल पहले, बट eventually it is the lines that make you when you say it. In fact, when I was a child, I didn't know ki koi writer hota hai. I thought actor hi bol raha hai. So it is actually silly of them to not go after it. But thankfully for us, Akshay sir,
has spoken. I'm sure if Salim Javed were writing these days, they would have been really frustrated.
I was not expecting this answer. I thought it's just that now when we discuss, it's like aaj aise koi likhne wale hai nahi. But now people are ready to write and I'm not ready to mop it. That is really something
but
new.
But having said that, I think, yeah, you were saying
suggestions.
I was saying
some people I want to name who have been exceptions in our journey so far. Mm-hmm. We have a very small journey yet. So Sanjay Neela Bhansali is somebody who really values a line for being a good line. He will stand up and start clapping if you write a good line for him. So that is the most brilliant thing about that director. Working with him is so satisfying. Be it our songs or be it our lines, he really values it. You know, he starts talking in our dialogues. Like, humse bhi usi mein baat karte hain. Wo to bada maza aata hai. And the other person is Akshay Kumar. Akshay sir has done, hopefully you'll all love it, in Toilet Ek Prem Katha, great justice to the language, the tone and the dialogue that we gave him. So these are two people who really, for whom you feel like writing those lines, you know.
Okay.
So that's the thing. The new age actors,
can you name the lesser center better?
Yeah, what are we talking about?
Kriti Sanand is very good with our lines. She's done a great job. Jim Sarb.
Ranveer is very good. Ranveer is Singh is very
of course,
good.
Yeah.
Oh, he is brilliant.
That, yeah.
He never, he would never question ki ye line yahan pe kyun hai. He'll say ki aur do de do. So he's that kind of an actor.
Yeah. Ranveer is firebrand. We have a chemistry with him which is like house on fire. So he's one person with whom we'd want to work again. He's super.
Right. And you know, we are talking about Ranveer, and when we kind of think about actors, you know, so when you are writing maybe a screenplay or maybe the script and you know who the actor is, that does that also kind of affect or influence your writing?
It's mostly a rewrite of the draft, which is not major. It's only a minor because, you know, everybody has a different style of talking. So unke liye wo easy ho jaye, khas karke aajkal to line jaisi nahi lagni chahiye. So to unko adapt karne ke liye hum log kabhi rewrite karte hain. That's the only thing. But apart from that, when we write, we don't keep anyone in mind. Because these days, you know, you have to incorporate any actor into any script.
Also, why we often hear that writers ekdam secluded ho jate hain aur kahin isolation mein jaake likhte hain, is that very important? Or
it's very important to find your space to write something. Mm-hmm. At the same time, it's very important for us, more than seclusion, it is the environment in which we are creating that film. So for example, Toilet Ek Prem Katha ki dialogues, we went to Mathura and we stayed there for a month and we wrote those dialogues and came back. Because we didn't want to get influenced by the... Because it's a tone. Hai. Mm-hmm. So if you come to Bombay, this starts affecting you. Your Hindi starts going in a certain way. So we choose that kind of seclusion, you know, for our scripts. For Raabta, we wrote mostly near water. So I don't know.
Also, our school of cinema is Sanjay sir. So he says ki kachre ke dher ke paas bhi writer ko baith ke likhna chahiye. So we are used to that also. Because writing on set is mostly like that. Ki aap kahin bhi baithe hote ho, kahin light lagi hai jaise, to wahan baithe ho, wahan likh rahe ho. So, but having said that, yeah, you have to create in a space. Theek hai, wo thoda sa zyada exaggerated hai ki I want my peace of mind and, you know, I want to be alone. And wo sab thoda exaggerated hai, but yeah.
But I can tell you for one thing, as a writer, what we feel is when we travel to a really nice location and we write, sometimes it really affects our efficiency. Matlab ki we end up writing more or better stuff. We are right now writing songs for Sunny Deol's son's debut film, mm-hmm. Palpal Dil Ke Paas. And it's amazing how we just create when we are in Manali. You know, it's different from being in Bombay. So that's something that really works.
And what is very challenging, because I keep on, you know, I've come across people who have a story, who have a script, but, you know, they're still struggling with it. Where to go? How does it work for them? Like, right. If you have anything, any guideline for them?
Okay. So basically, anyone who's looking forward to selling their script or to narrating their script to someone, first of all, you should try and meet this person, whoever you're aiming to meet. You know, it's difficult to get in touch with someone like that. But you can make a starting with approaching the production house. And they all production houses have a development team. So you can start meeting the development person over there, okay? If you can manage to get the number from somewhere, try and send the one line to the director. That's the best I can say. But a very important thing for a writer is to narrate it to their own people. Once you've written, try narrating it to 4-5 people in your own circle and get their reactions. They will be your most genuine critics. We do that very often and we've been doing it right from the beginning. You know, so that is something, we have a group of people who we narrate our scripts after writing to. If they trash it, then we know where we stand, you know. So that's the most important thing. Before you take it out to anyone else, your own people would let you know what it is all about.
So adding to that, it's basically when you're writing, there is a saying that when you write with the door closed. But when you narrate, you'd narrate with the doors open.
Wow.
So that anybody can come and sit and listen to you and give an opinion. So that's the tip that anybody can follow.
And there's a lot of scope. People are looking for good scripts. So one should not lose hope and keep at it. You know?
Yeah.
Where will you find such genuine people who are creating competition for themselves, giving them guidelines?
We really would want people to come in. Yeah? We would want some people to come in and write good stuff because, you know, we really feel there's a lack of good writers in the industry. We are all for it. You know?
Lastly, I would, this is my personal query as well. Why, you know, like having, you know, writing as a duo,
right.
Salim Javed saab ne bhi likha hai, though, and this is about creativity. So a lot of conflict of, you know, interest and must be happening. So why is it important? Or maybe it's just like, it just happens that two log saath mein likhte.
Yeah, I have lost all my hair.
Yeah, see, you can see, no, he's got bruises. He's very sure to
hide. Yeah, I'm hiding my bruises because we fight so much creating a
script. We really fight. We kill ourselves, each other. You know,
that's
that's the first test because if both of us have really, we are both independent writers in our own right, you know, so conflict to bound hai ki honi hi honi hai. At the same time, uske pros bhi hai ki there is a bouncing board constantly, you know. If there's an idea, then both of us can reflect it with each other. If the other person says, nahi, this is crap, you can't go ahead with it, then you obviously go ahead with, you know, something else. Or the other person helps in enriching it. So that way we would say we are as privileged as we are cursed.
Well put, actually.
Yeah.
So Garima and Siddharth, thank you so much for the valuable time and the valuable inputs and tips that you have given. Thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you.
Thank you.